In most softwares, and specifically 3D softwares, selection workflows are super important. Isolate, hide, organize, see through, lock, all those options will improve your work speed. When it comes to animation and rigging, we may have to deal with hundreds of controllers. And no matter how well the rig is made, it can be a hurdle to select what we want. I'm Pierrick from P2 Design, and here are some tips and tricks to master selection in Blender. Before we focus on animation and rigging, here are some common operations and shortcuts you should know. You can hide the selected items using H. Press Alt H to unhide, Shift H to hide everything else. You can enter local mode pressing the slash key. It will isolate your selection from everything else and it will center the view on your selection so that you can work on it. You can see you're in local mode in the top left corner. Just press slash again to exit local mode. Here we can see several cubes that are parented one to the other. Using Ctrl plus and minus, you can grow or shrink your selection following the next object in the hierarchy. This will work with chains of bones too. Speaking of hierarchy, you can go through the hierarchy using the open bracket. You can go back using the closed bracket. You can add selection following the hierarchy using the shift open and close brackets. And guess what? This will work with bones too. Here's one of the best shortcuts, Shift G to select grouped. Once you triggered it, you will have tons of options to choose from. You can pick all the children of the selected object or bone. You can pick the parent of the selected object or bone. If you choose siblings, it will pick the objects or bones that have the same label in the hierarchy. You can select the hooks of an object with a hook modifier. When you have a busy scene, it's sometimes complicated to select them. You can choose object by color, and by color, it's not the color of the material. If you go to the overlays, under color, you can choose to display the color of the object. You can set this color under the object properties. For example, I can give it a blue color, then copy this color and paste it over another object. And now when I press Shift G, I can use that as a selection trick. With this method, you can literally create millions of selection groups for your objects. This shortcut offers a variety of ways to select objects based on their properties. You can use the object type, you can use the light type, you can use the collection. Just give them a try so that you can add those to your workflow. This is great for modeling, but it can be great for animation and rigging too. Speaking of modeling, my friends at CG Boost just released a new course. The course is called Robotic Planet and was recorded by Louis Dumont, a fantastic Blender modeling specialist. I mean, he does also shading and lighting and animation too and rigging. I mean, everything. He does everything super well. And you can learn everything from him in this new course. When it comes to quality, CG Boost always deliver. Now beware, I watch a big part of the course, it's pretty high-paced, even though Louis explained everything he's doing. This is not a course for beginners, you should have a bit of experience using Blender before diving in. The outcome is great and you will learn a lot of effective workflow to model, texture, rig and animate funny characters. We saw that we can select grouped objects. But we can also use the shortcut Shift L to select different objects as long as they are sharing one data. As an example, I will give the same mesh data of the blue cube to those two gray cubes. And then when I press Shift L and I choose object data, materials are also shareable data. So I will press Shift L and choose material. And if I switch to material color, you can see that those five cubes add the same material. One rigger nightmare is to select overlapping bones. One trick is to display your bones as B-bones. Switch to edit mode, press Ctrl-Alt-S to change their scale. I mean not really their scale, but their thickness. So if you're a B-bone user, you probably already know that, and this way you can easily select one or the other bone. But if you're using octahedral bones, for example, well, that's a pain. But what you can do is use Alt-Right-Click to open the Select menu. This way you will have the list of all the overlapping bone and you will be able to select the bone you want in this list. Using Alt Shift plus right click allows you to add or remove selection. It's ideal to parent your bones or to create constraints. I almost always use the shortcut Shift Ctrl C to add my constraint to target. So it's super important for me to be able to choose whatever bone I want. This selection shortcut also works with overlapping objects. So it's also super handy for modeling. Now you may have different shortcuts. So if it doesn't work for you, go to Edit, Preferences, under Key Map, go in the 3D view and scroll until you reach the Select section. You will find there all the key combination for the different selection mode. You'll be able to see all the shortcuts available. And what you're looking for here is the option Enumerate. This is what will open the Select menu where you can pick overlapping items, bones, objects, etc. I got this tip from Hjalti Hjalmarsson from the Blender Studio. I never used it before, but I definitely will. This is a trident trick I created for my animation course Alive. You can get this trick for free on p2designacademy.com. Bone groups and layers are generally used to organize the rig. In pose mode, we can use the shortcut Shift-G to select bones that are part of the same layer or part of the same bone group. A bone can be assigned to only one group, but it can be assigned to multiple layers, but the number of layers is limited. Now let's say I want to work only on the fingers, which is pretty common. I may try to select them using the groups, but then I need to hide some of the other controllers, so I will only select my fingers, then press Shift-H, I want to hide another bone, and I do a mistake, so I press Ctrl-Z, and I try again to select my bones, and in this case I don't have overlapping bones, so that's quite okay, but on the face rig, for example, that would be a pain. Fortunately, Blender is shipped with a free add-on that will really help us. Go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and search Select. And you shall find the Add-on Animation Bone Selection Sets. This will add to your amateur properties a new Selection Sets panel. It works as bone groups or vertex group. You select your bones, you just create a new selection set, you give it a relevant name like hand.l, and you click Assign. I will create another group, selecting only the index this time, and call it index.l. And I can open my selection list group by pressing Shift-Alt-W. This way I can select the finger only if I want. To tweak its pose, I can create as many sets as I want, and bones can be part of several different selection sets. So as you go along animating, you can create new selection sets with chain of bones you use the most, and then press Shift-H to hide everything but those bones. This way you can clearly see what you're animating. Now, if you don't want to remember all the shortcuts, you can go to the Select menu and you will find the Bone Selection Set at the bottom of the menu. Then right-click and add it to your quick favorites. This way, at any time in pose mode, you can press the Q key to access your quick favorite and access your selection sets. I hope you learned something and all those little tips will help you accelerating and improving your workflow. This is the end of this video and I'll see you in the next one.